In this video, we'll talk about a very important prenatal diagnostic technique called amniocentesis. And as I said, it is prenatal diagnostic technique. That means it is used to detect the defects before the baby is born. While the baby is still in the mother's womb, that is the time when these defects can be detected. Now, first, we'll talk about the procedure. And then we will take up what for we can use it and what are the illegal aspects of this, why this has been misused. Now, the procedure is that we have to take out amniotic fluid. So first thing is, under ultrasound, which we call the sonography machine, by this ultrasound screening, the location of the fetus is seen on the screen, and by using a very thin needle, little bit of amniotic fluid is taken out. So amniotic fluid is taken out. Now, this fluid which is taken out is very less in quantity. Normally, when we talk of, it should not be more than 15 milliliters. But if less than that also is enough, then we don't take out that much of amniotic fluid. So, it is a very less quantity which is taken out. In the amniotic fluid are present cells. These cells are called fetal cells. If you remember, we were talking about embryonic development in the previous chapter. We said that when the embryo develops, the zygote goes on dividing. There are certain cells which form trophoblasts. Some cells, they get detached and come into this amniotic fluid. All the cells, they are dividing only by mitotic division. So, whatever is the genetic makeup of the zygote, the same genetic makeup is of all other cells. So, these fetal cells, they are cultured in vitro. In vitro means outside the body, but in the similar type of conditions. These cells are allowed to grow or culture or divide here. And then, karyotyping is done. Karyotyping is basically the cell division is arrested in metaphase where the chromosomes are thick. These chromosomes are stained, their pictures are taken, and then they are arranged in a systematic manner. That is called karyotyping. And when we see this complete picture, then we are able to find out chromosomal defects. So the step is, under observation, amniotic fluid is taken out, very small quantity. Amniotic fluid has fetal cells, they are cultured in vitro, and then they are karyotyped. After karyotype, when we see that picture, we are able to detect many different defects. So this is a procedure. One thing which is to be remembered, that it is under observation. And it is to be done by specialist, experienced people, because if that needle touches the embryo, then it can result into some kind of abnormalities. Plus, more amniotic fluid should not be taken out, because this amniotic fluid acts as a protective liquid. It also protects the fetus from these mechanical shocks. So procedure is like in three steps. It sounds very simple, but it's a very delicate and technical process. What for should this amniocentesis be done? What can be detected from this technique? First, we can detect chromosomal defects. These are basically congenital defects. And here we are talking of chromosomal defects. What exactly we mean by this? We just now talked about karyotype. Karyotype is going to be all 46 chromosomes in a pictorial form. Say for example, these are the chromosomes which are there, and because we are going to arrange them, we arrange them number wise. So this is first pair, second pair, and so on. Suppose this is the 21st chromosome. Normal individual should have a pair of all the chromosomes. We say we have 23 pairs. But if there is one extra chromosome, 21st chromosome, one extra, then this condition is known as trisomy of 21st chromosome, and it results into Down syndrome. Similarly, if X and Y chromosomes are there, then that also can be seen. If it is X and Y, we can identify the sex of the unborn baby or the embryo. So we can use it for sex determination. But this is one thing which has been illegally used. We'll come to that in a minute. Sex determination, because if we see X and Y chromosome, obviously we can understand that the fetus is male. And if we see X and X, then it is a female child. But sometimes, instead of X and X or X and Y, if it becomes XXY, then this disorder is known as Klinefelter syndrome. This is also a genetic disorder. Here the chromosome number is different. This was an autosomal disorder. This is a sex chromosomal disorder. Similarly, sometimes we may find only one X. It is known as X0 condition, or we call it Turner's syndrome. So these kind of conditions can be easily detected using this karyotyping under amniocentesis. Now coming to the sex determination. As I said, it's very easy. If we find two X chromosomes, it is a female fetus. If we find XY chromosome, it is a male fetus. Some people or some families, for some reason, they want boys in the family. And for that, they kill the female fetus. This is called female feticide. And because this female feticide is affecting the male-female ratio or the sex ratio, that is why this sex determination using amniocentesis has been banned. It is illegal. But under certain conditions, this can be done, but that is strictly decided by the doctor in charge. If that doctor feels, then only the sex will be identified. But normally, even if karyotyping is of all 46 chromosomes, so if the karyotype image is like this, it's going to have all chromosomes here, this X and Y chromosome, because this is 23rd pair. So this is at the last. So what they do is, they write something here. They don't show that picture. Because if you see it, X and Y chromosomes look different. So two X chromosomes are going to look different and X and Y are going to look different. So by looking at that picture also, one can identify that whether it is XX or XY. So they don't show that picture, that part. And that is why it is considered as, or it has been banned. Now, what exactly is the problem of female feticide? Female feticide is resulting into sex imbalance. That is, in a population of 1,000 males, there are only 930 approximately, 934 females. In any population, for normal reproduction, for every male, there has to be one female. So ratio should be 1:1. But this ratio is different. And in certain states, it is much less. For 1,000 males, there are 800 females or 700 females. So this female feticide is affecting the sex ratio in the population, which is not good for the population of or any society. So it can be used for sex determination, but it has been banned in India for controlling this female feticide. Another thing which can be detected are some metabolic disorders. Metabolic disorders, like certain enzyme related disorders. One such example is phenylketonuria, in which one enzyme is not produced properly, and that can also be detected by analysis of these chromosomes which are present, or the chromosomes which are taken from these fetal cells. And if one cell is showing this defect, obviously it is in all other cells. Now, if something major is detected, that means if something of this kind is detected, which is going to be very, very harmful for the newborn or for the individual, then medical termination of pregnancy can be done. This is called MTP. MTP. Medical termination of pregnancy. But this is only if the doctor prescribes. That is, it is something which is going to be very dangerous for the baby as well as for the mother, or the baby which is going to be born would be having so many defects that the life of the baby would become miserable. In that situation, this can be prescribed. But this is legal. But for that, the doctor has to take the decision. And this, because of sex determination, this cannot be done. Like if the sex of the fetus is identified as female, then MTP cannot be done. Then it would be considered as illegal. But if something of this type is there or is detected, then the doctors can advise MTP. So this is amniocentesis, very helpful technique. Before birth, the defects of the fetus can be detected and steps can be taken for that. But there are certain illegal practices which are being done. So to keep check on those practices, only one part, that is sex determination, has been banned.